Assalamualaikum guys, how are you? Hope you are doing well. Today we have to discuss applied linguistics. Here we will take a general overview of applied linguistics. Before going to applied linguistics, we have to differentiate between linguistics and applied linguistics. So that it may get clear what linguistics is and what applied linguistics is. So when we talk about linguistics, as you already know, that it's the scientific study of language. Because linguistics do work on specific languages, but the primary goal is to understand the nature of language in general. So linguistics is basically concerned with the nature of language and communication. When we talk about any language, there are three aspects to the study of any language. These include language form, language meaning, and language use in discursive and communicative contexts. Linguistics basically deals with the study of particular languages, and here the search is for general properties common to all languages, or it may be a large group of languages. There are certain questions to which linguistics tries to answer. For example, what distinguishes human language from other animal communication systems? It means that what's the difference between human language and the other animal communication systems. The other question which linguistics tries to answer is, what features are common to all human languages? Another question to which linguistics tries to answer is that how are the modes of linguistic communication related to each other? As you know, that there are different modes of communication like speech, writing, like sign language of the deaf, etc. So linguistics tries to find the relationship among all these modes of communication. The questions to which linguistics tries to answer are like this. How is language related to other types of human behavior? So here the language relationship with human behavior is focused. Then what's language and how is it organized? How is it analyzed? How are its units discovered and tested, etc.? So these were the questions, and there are some other questions too to which linguistics tries to answer. Now we come to branches of linguistics. So it deals with a vast variety of subfields. There are several branches like pragmatics, phonology, phonetics, morphology, syntax, and semantics. Linguistics sometimes works as interdisciplinary study. Actually, interdisciplinary studies involve two or more academic disciplines which are considered distinct. The most common interdisciplinary branches of linguistics are as follows, like historical linguistics, which studies the relationship of linguistics with history. Then there is sociolinguistics, which studies the relationship of society to the language or linguistics. Then there is psycholinguistics, which focuses the relationship of psychology and linguistics. Then there is ethnolinguistics or anthropological linguistics. Then there is computational linguistics and neurolinguistics. Now let us discuss the brief history of applied linguistics. When did it all begin? The term applied linguistics was coined by Anglo-Americans. It was founded first at the University of Edinburgh School of Applied Linguistics in 1956, then at the Center of Applied Linguistics in Washington, D.C. in 1950. The British Association of Applied Linguistics was established in 1967. Its aims were the advancement of education by fostering and promoting, by any lawful charitable means, the study of language use, language acquisition, and language teaching, and the fostering of interdisciplinary collaboration in this study. Between 1960s and 1970s, there was a misconception, and during this time, applied linguistics was taken about only for language teaching. As we previously have discussed, that linguistics is the study of language, and applied linguistics deals with the real-world problems regarding language. The purpose of applied linguistics is to solve the real-world problems about language. According to Brumfitt, 1997, applied linguistics deals with the theoretical and empirical investigation of real-world problems in which language is a central issue. According to Schmidt and Selsey, Mercier, 2002, applied linguistics is using what we know about language, how it is learned, and how it is used in order to achieve some purpose or solve some problems in the real world. It means that we use our knowledge of language, we concerned with how language is learned and how language is used, and the purpose of all these things is to solve the problems regarding language. Traditionally, the primary concerns of applied linguistics have been second language acquisition theory, second language pedagogy, and the interface between the two, according to Schmidt, 2002. According to Grab, 2002, the focus of applied linguistics is on trying to resolve language-based problems that people encounter in the real world. Whether they be learners, they may be teachers, supervisors, academics, lawyers, service providers, or those who need social services. These may be test takers, policy developers, dictionary makers, translators, or a whole range of business clients. So, in short, we can say that applied linguistics tries to resolve language-based problems that people encounter in the real world. According to Kaplan, 2002, linguists are concerned with the analysis of new data rather than continue to argue new theory. And according to Kaplan and Grabe, 2000, the term applied linguistics raises fundamental difficulties. If for no other reason, then it is difficult to decide on what accounts as linguistics. Given these difficulties within linguistics proper, it is perhaps unfair to expect clean solutions and clear delimitations for defining applied linguistics researches in a vast variety of different fields like language acquisition, language teaching, literacy, gender studies, language policy, speech therapy, discourse analysis, censorship, workplace communication, media studies, translation, lexicography, forensic linguistics, etc. There are three main defining characteristics of applied linguistics: that it is autonomous, it is multidisciplinary, and it's problem solving. When we talk about applied linguistics, it uses and draws on the theory from other related fields concerned with language and generates its own theory in order to find solutions to language-related problems and issues in the real world. Practical concerns have an important role in shaping the questions that applied linguistics tries to answer. Applied linguistics tries to answer the language-related problems and tries to solve these language-related problems of learners, teachers, academics, lawyers, translators, test takers, and service providers, etc. So at the end, we can conclude that linguistics is a scientific study of a particular language, and applied linguistics tries to solve the problems regarding language in the real world. Thank you very much.